So now the next step we talk about the so-called Laplace transform. So why do we need a new transform here? So as a motivation, remember the Fourier transform. Had quite a very, very convenient feature that if we have a convolution operation, yeah, so if we have something like x of t convolved with y of t, then in the frequency spectrum, so if we have got x of f, then this turns into a multiplication operation here. Multiplication operation. Yeah, so this was quite convenient that we're getting rid of this convolution operation here. So that's a convolution. So now the problem is that the Fourier transform is non-causal, Let's introduce a transform which works with causal signals. So a transform which works with causal signals. And this is called the so-called Laplace transform. So that's defined as H of S. So we don't have a frequency in here. And then this is running from 0 to infinity, h of t, and then e to st dt. So if we just compare this again to our Fourier transform here, yeah, so that's our Fourier transform here. This was from minus infinity to plus infinity here. And then h of t, and then e to minus j omega t dt here. So the integration only runs from 0 to infinity. And the other interesting thing is this j omega here is replaced by this s term here. So s can be any complex number. Whereas obviously here, this is j omega. And we directly see if we are substituting the j omega in here, we're getting something like a Fourier transform back. So it's a bit like a generalized Fourier transform, Laplace transform. So the Laplace transform has a couple of really interesting properties.